I just hope that you're soaking up the atmosphere of this game as we are here at Football Park. A tremendous sight, tremendous crowd, great atmosphere, and a great game on our hands. 8-6 at halftime, West Adelaide leading Norwood 5-5. And the winner of tonight's game, grand final, will receive $30,000, including a trophy. And to the loser goes $20,000. Plus, there'll be a $500 Man of the Match award, and that will be announced after the game has been completed here tonight.
And a very quick one, Rick, at this stage of the game, who would be your Man of the Match?
Well, I think that Clayton Lamb on the halfback flank, or Dale Woodhall up forward. He's kicked 5 goals. He's had a couple of easy ones, but Clayton Lamb has done a superb job on the halfback flank.
David Payne, the young Norwood Rover, half forward, has also been in the thick of things. He's contributed well too, Ian.
Yes, he has, and he's playing in his second year of football.
So the action about to start at the third quarter, with just 19 points separating the two sides. And what a crackerjack game we saw in the first half. There's number 26 for West Adelaide, Stephen Miller. And the Bloods are straight into attack. Aishu lifted in that second quarter. Keith Thomas. Gallagher looks a little short in his action. Goes out wide, looking for that man I was talking about just a few moments ago, Payne, the talented Vardaniga. Around Rennie, although Rennie finally lays a hand on him. The pass is short, and it's successful. We'll just wait and see who it is. A player in trouble. It is David Payne, and he has hurt himself diving for that ball. And Gary McIntosh will take the free kick.
Das, I think that big Mark Dreyer ran in and just sort of couldn't stop himself there. I think he just ran into the back of him.
So Payne's still injured. He's being treated by the trainer. As McIntosh goes long, looking for Michael Annie. Chance for Grosser. Vardaniga. Grosser close to the line. Gets a kick back. But the boundary umpire signifies that the ball is out of play. And we've been playing for just 1 minute in the third quarter. And still 19 points separating the two sides.
Yes, 3 goals, 1 the difference. And David Payne has still not moved as the ball will go into the area that David Payne is in. They've got him up on his feet now. A little chaps up, but for the moment, Shaw kicks the ball right from where David Payne is. Over the top of the Lester Ross. Chance now for Norwood to move it to Gallagher, who looks a bit stiff and jumpy in his movements. Out it came to Bennett in turn. Chance now for Filkey. Filkey kicking forward underneath it, and there's a good mark to Bruce Ritter. Bruce Winter really is a fine footballer. Started with Sturt, plays for Norwood, over towards Scanlon, very close to the boundary line, and out of play.
There's Payne, who's still in a bit of pain, pardon the pun. John Hall, 37. 15 for West Adelaide is Carl Herbert. Scanlon tackles him. Umpire Argent in for the bounce. So still the scores at 19 points the difference. Michael Aish had 13 possessions in the first half. Michael Taylor was a bit quiet. McIntosh was the ever-reliable McIntosh. Stephen Miller. Now Jarvis. Jarvis. Miller gets it out wide. Warhurst. Keith Thomas. Thomas, who had 4 kicks and 5 handballs in that first half, goes back towards the centre of the ground. Oh, Michael Annie was held without the ball, and he'll take the free kick.
Jim Michael Annie takes full use of his 15 metres. Down to Roberts. That's a good capture. That's a strong mark to Neville Roberts. So far in the game, number 9 for Norwood, Neville Roberts, their captain, has kicked a goal. Now he's about 45 metres out from goals. Anything up to 40 metres, he would be the straightest kick in Australia. He doesn't chance his length, and he fended it off to Keith Thomas. And now Keith Thomas. No one on his mark. Long penetrating kick, it's got the distance, and it can't get much closer than that. It's hit the post.
Well, bad luck there for Norwood. Neville Roberts took the great mark. He passed it off to the Norwood player there in Thomas, and unfortunately hit the post.
The outer side go West Adelaide. Grosser gets out of trouble. He has Dreher short at centre-half back. Dreher in turn has Cantor Laftis on a long lead. Now here's a build-up for West Adelaide. Looses Muret. That's ignored. Dreher instead gives support. Luders. Randall Bennett. Run a long way, an awful long way, and he's kicked a long way, and he's kicked magnificently! A goal, a great goal!
What a magnificent goal there from West Adelaide. Going out onto the left foot in Bennett, shooting directly at the front of goal. Here we see it on the Channel 9 screen, over there to Luders. He handballs quickly to Bennett, shapes up, runs around the mark, fires it into the open goal and brings up his second goal.
Back live as Neil Button comes onto the ground. Norwood now move the ball through Michael Aney to McIntosh. McIntosh to Ace. Ace driving the ball right in towards the square with his 10th kick. No one can get it except Roberts. Roberts has a snap at the goal. He kicks it out of play on the full under intense pressure.
Coming out after half-time, I know how he feels. He'd be a little bit stiff. Most of the Norwood players would be. And here it comes, punched away, down to Roberts, snapped, but unfortunately caught the outer side and went out of bounds on the full.
Lester Ross drives Norwood back into attack. Roberts in trouble. Borchardt takes it, goes short to Bennett. Now let's go back to Neville Roberts. He's laid prostrate on the ground at centre-half forward. The trainers are now getting to him. But really, as he flew for that ball, he got tangled up in that pack and is in trouble. Neil Balm's in trouble and Norwood are in trouble. Roberts still hasn't moved. I'm trying to signalling for a stretcher, or is it from the doctor? Meanwhile, the action is at the other end of the ground where Filkey has it for West Adelaide. Filkey. Kicks it long, but the umpire's seen an infringement. It's going against West Adelaide, and it's going Norwood's way, and it'll be taken by Michael Ace. So this will be his 11th kick, and Roberts is on his feet. That's good news. But by golly, he still looks a bit groggy. Michael Annie from behind, Rennie from the front, and Michael Annie's been paid.
Well, it's going to go into the forward area. Button using his body and brute strength. But a little excessive brute strength, and the free kick goes the way of Williams. The former All-Australian kicks back towards the centre wing. Michael Aney up, couldn't take the mark because Lester Ross is there. And the little back pocket player a long way from home, down towards the left half forward flank. They set themselves. Vardeniger out to McIntosh. Clever play by McIntosh. Oh, good football. Here's the opportunity for Vardeniger. Lines up the goals and shoots it through for 1 point.
Yes, well, there's also bad luck from Norwood. They're not having much luck at the moment. They're just chipping away. West Adelaide got a good start, and they're starting to sort of just chip away and see if they can get back into this game.
23 points of difference as Michael Annie marks the kick in. Now, he's a good 60 metres out. The distance will probably be too far for him, although he goes back an extra couple of yards. Very straight leg, very good timing. Towards centre full forward area, Button couldn't mark it. The West Adelaide defence is firm. Muret's loose. So's Filkey. Filkey with exhilarating pace. Bursts through the centre, kicks long towards centre half forward, but there's a great mark taken in defence by Rowan Hallier. Herbert was in there like a little bloodhound. And Hallier just pushed him aside. Taylor, who I believe is now playing in the back pocket. Filkey's over the mark. There must be a 15-metre penalty.
Gus, I think that West Adelaide, every time the ball gets into the half-forward plate, they run in and they give a free-away. They not only give a free-away on the grandstand side, but I've noticed they've done it every time the ball gets into the attack of in the defence of Norwood.
Well, it is delaying the progress of the side trying to get out of defence, and it looks as though it's a set plan set up by Carr. The free has gone the way of Shaw. And West Adelaide, who lead by 23 points, as Philip Gallagher leaves the field, go forward again. Filkey has it at centre wing, and the commentator is Ian Aitken.
8 minutes into the third quarter, number 10 was the kick to Filkey towards Miller. Miller takes a good mark at centre half forward. Herbert signalling he wants it, but it's down towards Woodall. Couldn't take the mark on the ground. It's Carl Herbert. Tried to scoop it away. Big John Hall and turned to Fantasia. On to Greg Thomas. The tackling and pressure is fierce as Murette bursts through the pack, lines up the goals and bangs it through for 1 point.
Well, they're the goals that Murette, with his brilliance, ball-getting ability, should have made dead sure of that one and let sort of Norwood come back a little bit.
Winter to the outer side, looking for Hall and finds him. So four straight kicks in the game. Norwood have added 2 points in this third quarter. West Adelaide 1-1. Button had front position. Lamb, who played brilliantly in the first half, heads for Cantalaftis. Over the top goes Cantalaftis. Here's an opportunity now for Conlon. Bernie Conlon boots it towards centre half forward. Oh, but it's all Norwood in the way. And John Hall takes the defensive mark. He lays it off to Scanlon. Scanlon in turn to Winter. Keith Thomas on a long lead, and that's a good pass from Bruce Winter. Thomas wastes no time, but the kick is very high. Ace has front position, off courage. Lost his head in the process, but by geez, a great play, and what courage he shows.
Well, when the going gets tough, the tough get going, and this is what a great little player Michael Ace is, and he needs to too, because Norwood in a little bit of trouble here. He needs to really get his act together and see if he can start them going.
As West Adelaide move it away through Dreher, Michael Ace to support Rick Davies has had 12 kicks in the game so far. John Hall to Michael Taylor, who's starting to come back into some good touch. Mr. Ross was tackled rather high and out of play. John Cale looking on very pensively, the professional coach. Went to Collingwood as full-time coach. Mr. Ross got it. Looks for support and Michael Taylor. Hamilton in trouble. Well, it's good to see that Herbert's okay. Hamilton boots it off the ground looking for Luders. McKinnon bursting through. A long hand pass to Hilkey. Hilkey forced to kick with his left foot and is not accurate and gets through for 1 point.
Well, Norwood putting a little bit more pressure on the West Adelaide forwards now. That lady would be feeling a lot better because that one missed. But Norwood are starting to chip away now. They're starting to relax themselves and get back into this game.
Scanlon. Can Norwood fight back? Scanlon has it in the back pocket. The difference is 25 points. It was 19 at half time. Lamb. Scanlon trying very hard. Michael Taylor shifted to the back pocket. Fantasia now. And Norwood out of trouble towards centre wing. Micken and Michael Annie. Dreher goes in strongly, as does Michael Ace. Now, where's the support? Here it is from Vardaniga. Vardaniga's kick only covers about 8 metres. Thomas had the front position. That's Keith Thomas. The handball's out wide to Lachlan. Dreher trying to burst his way through, couldn't. And finally, players stack up, and there'll be a bounce. So 11, almost 12 minutes gone in this third quarter. And 5-7 Norwood play West Adelaide 9-8.
21-minute quarters in the third and fourth quarter, plus time on, as Keith Thomas to Fantasia. Norwood worked the ball down around the outer side of the oval, in fact, very close to the outer side, as it's picked up by their captain in West Adelaide's captain in Borchard. Rennie grabbed and grabbed very quickly, but out of play is the ball. Michael Rennie, number 36, a very, very big crowd. And it has been and is a superb night of football, as Michael Aney does well for Lachlan to get into the action. McIntosh in turn back to Michael Aney to Thomas. Good use of handball here. Fantasia tries one too many. Conlon takes possession of the ball and drives it down towards the centre half forward position. Players up, players down. Luders and Bruce Winter. Oh, he's as cool as a cucumber as Bruce Winter. Always does something reliable. Vardaniga kicked a couple. Carl Herbert has possession for Westies. The Bloods go forward, down, taken by Murette. Mr. Immaculate, the Luders, who heard the call from Woodall, and Woodall, who in the first half booted five and has now got the opportunity to make it six.
Very relaxed player is Woodall. He seems to wait back into the square, makes a short lead, and the West Adelaide players up forward, the Murettes, the players there, magnificent.
Well, Woodall, West Adelaide at half-time rate 6, now they're 9-8. So they've kicked 1-2 prior to that kick from Dale Woodall, and that's his sixth.
Six goals to Dale Woodall. Well, let's face it, he's been the forward that's... Well, he's won the game, let's face it. As I said before, waits in the square, makes the short lead, and then what makes a very, very good full forward, he's a very straight kick.
It was Carl Herbert that had it. Now watch Luders. Murat takes it. He sees Luders on the lead. Called out by Woodhall, and Luders responded well. Woodhall has booted six, and West Adelaide 10-6 lead Norwood 5-7.
Michael Aish again drives Norwood out of the square, down towards the full forward position. Roberts on the bottom of the pack there. Button there to give support. And Neville Roberts, Neil Baum. Oh, well, he should shrug his head. Roberts in a bit of trouble. Back with the action. Ketalaptis going in there trying to get it. Hasn't got it yet, but he's good enough to knock it away. Lachlan in trouble. A long hand pass back to Fantasia. Not knowing what to do with it because the pressure's intense. Back it came to Lachlan, to Thomas. And now Thomas, too far to score, doesn't try. McIntosh, and McIntosh takes it. Back with Roberts. Looks as though he could have a bit of cramp, or he seems okay now. And Craig McIntosh, who has had, this will be his eighth kick, and they need this goal from McIntosh. The distance is okay, and the accuracy is going to be not quite good enough. 1 point.
Well, McIntosh there, as they Norwood, as we looked at Big Barmy there, he'd be worrying what he could do up forward, but unfortunately, the West Adelaide defence is just far too strong.
Rennie, Williams support. Well, they're fiddling around here. Button after them, but Rennie gets clear. West Adelaide towards centre wing. Outer side. Clayton Lamb up and takes a good mark. Boy, he's played well, Clayton Lamb. And West Adelaide now move it forward. Drouillard kicks towards centre half forward. Picked up cleverly by Luders. They can see ground, but retain possession as Bennett bangs it in towards the square. Hallier from behind. Hits it clear. Puts it out of play. So almost 16 minutes gone in this third quarter. The Escort Cup Grand Final is Barry Downs, the team manager of West Adelaide, and Leon Grosser comes off the interchange bench. Keith Thomas has it for Norwood at the other end of the ground. Bruce Winter comes clear. Now he really has kicked well tonight, Winter. Looking out wide for Vardeninger. With him, Lamb. Oh, he pulled on the arm of Vardeninger, unseen by the umpire. Lamb gives it to Bennett. Bennett goes in short, looking for Murat in the pocket and finds him. Brilliant football again by West Adelaide. And the Bloods are really going to be a threat in 85. Mark my words. Murat's back. The last time he played with the club, they won a grand final. And will history repeat itself? This will be his seventh kick. Peter Murat has not kicked a goal to date. And if he bangs this one through, they'll go six goals clear. It's on its way. It's a drop punt. It's a terrific kick. A goal to Murat. And West Adelaide, 11-8, lead Norwood, 5-8.
Well, Peter Murat's lost nothing from going up to Broken Hill. I thought that Vardeninger had the open run out on the outer side. But to Clayton Lamb, who's been my best man on the ground, you can see this, handballs it over to Bennett. He swings the ball around. And watch Murat position himself over the top, watching the ball. And it wouldn't be easy out there, I'll tell you. And goes back and kicks a magnificent goal.
It was a beaut kick, wasn't it? As Hamilton gets it across. But McIntosh intercepts and does it very well. Norwood really need to run on and run on very quickly. Fantasia driving the ball down to Roberts. Roberts, who's in plenty of trouble so far, takes the mark. Neville Roberts, been told to play on. Ball to the ground, and Westies come right over the top. Norwood are in plenty of trouble at the moment. They were trailing at half-time by 19 points. They don't really look as though they're doing it well enough. Rick Davies said West Adelaide are a very scrappy side. I wonder if he'd like to still stick with that opinion.
Well, when I say scrappy, and I mean that they're at the player, they're at the ball. Scrappy is a funny word, but they're always make it hard for the opposition.
But Roberts! Oh, that's a superb mark. Fantastic mark, Neville Roberts. He's been knocked to the ground, he's had cramp, and he still finds the energy and the courage to fly over the pack. And let's have a look at that. Oh, fantastic, Mark Roberts. So if ever Norwood needed Neville Roberts to boot a goal for them, they do now. They trail by six goals. This will reduce it to five. 15 metres out. Does he miss those? No, he doesn't. That's his second.
Well, what a magnificent mark there by Neville Roberts. And let's face it, what would Neil Barn be thinking? What could he possibly do? There he is. What could he do? He's moved Big Button to full forward. He's had Michael Annie at centre-half forward. His main strike rate is Neville Roberts. He must fire for Norwood to win the game. And what a magnificent captain's effort that was to kick a much-needed goal.
And Neville Roberts is virtually on one leg at the moment. But I think Neville Roberts, even on one leg, is still a superb footballer. As Norwood now, knowing that they're in trouble, McIntosh bursting out of the centre, but well tackled and tackled by Hamilton, who recovers brilliantly, drives it down to Murette, who is emerging as the most effective player on the field, down in towards the forward pocket. Bruce Winter, a superb game in defence and does it all the time. Up over the top to Stephen Miller, a beautiful mark. Miller, rangy, over 6 foot, only 22 years of age. A beautiful kicker of the ball, and he drives it right in towards the square. Off hands it comes. The chance for Luders. Luders playing in a forward pocket, but the goal umpire has signalled that the ball was rushed through for 1 point.
The value of the fresh player coming on there at half-time. Young Miller, fresh legs, came right over the top there to take a great mark.
Winter goes short. Ooh, met solidly was Greg Thomas, but fairly. He has it at centre half back. Nobody's standing his mark, so he's off. Grandstand side. Keith Thomas. Michael Annie in the middle of the pack, and he takes it. Now Jim Michael Annie at centre wing, flanked by Jarvis. Pretty quiet one in tonight, Jarvis. A high kick looks for Button. Roberts is there also. Cantor left us the crumbs. Does the mopping up operation. West Adelaide through Rennie get clear towards centre wing. It's too long for Michael Annie. Jarvis in close with him, does the shepherding, but Michael Annie walks the ball, in fact, over the line and out of play. So 20 minutes gone in this third quarter, remembering, of course, that the third quarter is 21 minutes plus time on. So is the last quarter. And if we're going to have an exciting finish, then Norwood really have to get on with this business and get on with it quickly to get back in the game. They're trying valiantly, but every attempt that they make is being met head-on by West Adelaide. As Hamilton kicks his ninth kick towards centre-half forward, Jarvis had front position, Warhurst run down, in the back says the umpire, and terrific Tom takes it at centre-half back.
Well, Norwood to me looks starting to be a little bit tired here. They're starting to run a little bit slower, in my opinion, and West Adelaide, well, they'll be the fittest side in the competition. They seem to be running on.
Those comments came to you from Rick Davies as West Adelaide scooped the ball through the centre of the ground, kicking down towards centre-half forward. Luders over the top, couldn't take it. McKinnon does and does it very well. On it goes to Des Herbert. Murette's the danger man. Pokes it out the front. And this will be goal number 7 to Dale Woodall. And he would be the best man on the ground tonight as he kicked the ball right out of the football park arena.
Well, how easy can you get it? Dale Woodall, not a big player. I thought he was bigger than that. Luders, renowned for a big jump, puts it over the top to Herbert. He in turn, with his left hand, you watch Murette, draws the player. How easy is it?
Rick, they're so quick and so strong, West Adelaide, at the moment. Did you see McKinnon just burst through that pack? He's only 5'10".
Well, as I said before, Dust, scrappy play. See, they're winning it easy.
At the bounce, Greg Thomas takes it for the Redlegs. Forward they go. Keith Thomas, Cantalaftis, controls the ball beautifully. Forced onto his left foot. Grosser. In trouble, Carl Herbert. Michael Taylor. Lester Ross. Let's wait on the umpire. He's picked a free kick out. It's going to Lester Ross for a push. And he's got it at centre wing. No, it's going back to Greg Thomas. Well, Greg Thomas now goes long, looking for Michael Annie. Dreher had front position. And umpire Argent has sorted out another free kick. And again, it's going to Norwood. And this time it's Jim Michael Annie. Well, he's within range as John Carl comes down to the ground level. Michael Annie, instead of kicking long, saw Roberts on a lead. And the Rock has it at centre-half forward. Ian Aitken told you a few moments ago that from within 40 metres, he's the best shot for goal in Australia. He still agrees, still says that he's right. let's watch Roberts. I agree with you, Ian. And I bet you he lets us both down. No, he hasn't. He is the best kick in Australia from 40 metres, and Roberts has booted his third.
Well, Michael Andy's done a fantastic job wherever he's played, whether it be centre-half forward or on the half-forward flank. And he's taken about five or six marks there, and he's passed the ball off magnificently to Roberts. And to the old war horse's credit, he's kicked another goal.
So there it is. Three-quarter time at Football Park in the grand final of the Escort Cup. Norwood 7-8-50, Trial West Adelaide 12-9. We'll take a break and then come back with the last quarter. Three-quarter time in the grand final of the Escort Cup, and West Adelaide 12-9 lead Norwood 7-8. Ken, the question on everybody's mind is, can the Norwood side come back?
Well, David, I believe they can. You never ever say that Norwood are gone at three-quarter time. Of course, they're five goals down, but there were signs there that the Norwood were coming back. But take nothing away from West Adelaide. Each time that Norwood has got that step closer, the Bloods have broken away. But Ian, I believe Norwood can come back. I really believe that Norwood have been absolutely astounded by West Adelaide's vigour and their aggression tonight.
Well, Norwood have the ability to come back, but whether they can do it tonight, I don't know, because West Adelaide in that third quarter booted four and Norwood were only able to boot two. Neil Baum is in there. He certainly believes that these players can come back and win it. He's a very, very exalted coach, and he's a fine coach. There's no doubt about that. And this is just one of the other sides of Neil Baum that we don't often see too much about. And if you can lip read, well, you might be able to understand what he said. I did.
What happened? What a character. A quiet man in the rooms and around the ground, but they tell me, Kim, when he sits on the bench, as we saw, there goes berserk.
Well, you're right there. He gets his point over to his players. He's a well-respected coach, but it's going to take all of Barnes' magic in this last quarter. They are going with the breeze, but it will take all of Barnes' magic to get them back. But, David, I have never, ever seen a West Adelaide side so aggressive and at the same time use the football so superbly.
Their pace, their strength, their skills are fantastic. And I just can't see, I don't think I've ever seen a better West Adelaide side than the performance we've seen tonight, particularly that first quarter when they were absolutely electrifying. I don't see any side at the moment from the size that we've seen in the Escort Cup getting close to West Adelaide.
Are you surprised, David, they are so aggressive when, okay, the last two or three years they've been coached by probably the strongest coach for many, many years, Neil Curley. I didn't believe they could find so much aggression.
Well, I think it's probably the experience that John Carles had in Victoria. I hate to say that, but I really think that is the reason here.
Well, yes, I think that's a fair point, but I think there's one other thing that they are doing. They are applying enormous pressure.
Well, they are indeed, and can Norwood come back? That's the big question to be answered in the last 21 minutes plus time on. We'll take a break now and then come back to show you that last quarter.
When you buy a new car, price is a major consideration, and that's why we're extending our 1,066 cashback offer on new Sigma and Colt.
Welcome back to Football Park. West Adelaide 12-9, leading Norwood 7-8. Umpire Arjun has the ball in his hand. Players about to start in the last quarter. Five goals, one the difference. To take you to the action, Ian Aitken.
Well, this is it. You either win 30,000 or you win 20,000. But the winner will get the 30 as immediately West Adelaide go forward through Conlon. Back there is Rowan Hellyer, one of the exciting youngsters at Norwood, as Lester Ross is in flight. Can't control the ball, it's taken away from him, but to infringement. And Carl Herbert was the offender. Number 15, Lester Ross, number 10. 21 minutes plus time on. Justin Scanlon. And the Norwood players looking a little weary. There's down ground that goes to Michael Aish. He's had a good game, Michael Aish. Had a superb game last week, looking to give it to McIntosh. McIntosh has been a little quiet in the last couple of weeks. Back it goes to Asian, turn towards centre full forward. Michelani up behind. There's a good mark. The umpire is not going to pay it to Shaw. He's going to give it to Michelani by the look of it. No, he's not. He takes the easy way out and bounces.
Well, I can't believe that. It was Michelani's mark for Shaw. Umpire Rick Kinnear will call for a further bounce down, but gee whiz, I was always told the golden rule was to play the man in front, and that was Jim Michelani on that occasion. The bounce. Candelaftis back towards centre half back. Stephen Miller out to the half back flank. Lester Ross is there, number 10. He's full of courage. Overruns the ball, butters up again. Scrambly football as players throw their body over the ball. Stephen Miller is there, and Craig Barnes got his head in his hand again. I reckon he's aged about 20 years tonight, Barmy. He's really given those children a thrashing. McIntosh comes away with the ball. Tries to draw the player. Goes onto his right foot, into the pocket. But back there is Clayton Lamb.
Clayton Lamb, who's played a superb game in defence for the Bloods. Kicks them clear towards centre wing. From behind it was Miller, Filkey, Randall Bennett. Gee, Bennett's played well also. Bennett had 12 kicks and 6 handballs to three-quarter time. Now Norwood go forward from Keith Thomas. The big bear button in front, can't mark it. Chance for Scanlon, pops it over the top. Here's a go for Roberts. Very hurried that one, just too much. Not enough talking from the players around Neville Roberts. Hurried the shot and missed.
Very unusual to see Neville Roberts do that. It's Craig Williams. Drives the ball towards centre half-back. Knocked on very cleverly by Muret. He really is a brilliant player. Grant Filkey has tremendous speed. Down towards Lutus, couldn't find him. Taken by Winter. Best man on the ground tonight gets $500. It's not going to be easy either to judge that best man on the ground. Number 31 is Jim Michelani. West Adelaide at the moment look as though they have it in their control. It's 30 points the difference. But I still say that Norwood have got the ability to come back and win this game as Carl Herbert kicks down in towards the full forward position. Oh, Bruce Winter, you really are a champion. There is no doubt about that. He's played an absolute magnificent game. This will be his 10th kick as he comes down looking for McIntosh. McIntosh met very heavily, but he's rough, tough, and not terribly handsome.
Oh, he loves it tough, McIntosh. He really does. Comes away towards Jarvis. His kick to the half-forward flank. Var Danninger's there. He's played pretty well tonight. Muret, number 10. Rowan Hellier. Muret, look at that handball. Fantastic football. Back to Johnny Candelaftis. Very cool, calm and collected. Sells the dummy. Goes towards the half-forward line. Stephen Miller. Short, shocking kick. Richard Hamilton. In towards centre half-forward. Lutus up high. Ball to ground. Body, vigorous football. Michael Taylor. Over to Craig Barm. Barm. Keith Thomas, Norwood working the ball out of the fence. Runs through centre half, back in towards centre. The poor kick, and Dreher is back there, and he'll take them out.
Dreher slips it to Muret. West Adelaide forward again. Muret has a bounce, now goes long. In look, oh, what a magnificent kick from Muret. From the moment it left, his boot, it was going to find its mark. And that mark, of course, is Dale Woodhall. And there's a 15-metre, and that's ridiculous football from Craig Barnes. A 15-metre penalty against him has brought Woodhall to them, in fact, putting to the line. Now, he can't miss from here. He's already booted at 7, and there's Neil Barm, who's most disgusted, I'm sure, with that performance. 8 to Woodhall. And West Adelaide are 13-9, Norwood 7-9.
Well, we've still got time to go. It's nearly 5 minutes. In fact, it is 5 minutes have gone in the game. And that might be just about the best man on the ground, either Woodall or Muret. And isn't he a classy footballer? He went back to Broken Hill where he was born. He started his career at Woodville, remarkably. They swapped him with Ken Deards, did West Adelaide. And a little bit of help there.
Michael Aish. What an outstanding performance has been by West Adelaide. 13-9, 87, Norwood 7-9, 51. Umpire Rick Kinnear, one of the senior umpires in South Australia, in this game coming to you on Nine's Wide World of Sports.
Richard Hamilton takes it away from the centre for the Bloods once more. 10th kick by Hamilton. Carl Herbert on his wrong foot. Kicks high towards centre-half. What was courage again from Winter, backing into the ball. Or running with the ball, backing into the play. And Winter comes grandstand side. Ace, who had 21 possessions to three-quarter time, has been paid the mark a little fortuitously. And this will be his 15th kick. 8 handballs included. Mickham from behind. Keith Thomas, the clever Keith Thomas. Gallagher's had a quiet one. Out wide. Bad handball. And West Adelaide are strong and determined. Rennie typifies that. So does Filkie. Cantalapis making space. On the left foot. Bangs it in towards the pocket. 10 kicks to Cantalapis. That one's not well directed. Carl Herbert can't get to it. And it's out of play. 15,020 people here to witness the grand final of the Escort Cup.
And it really has been a spectacular game of football. Rough, tough, not always pretty. But West Adelaide have displayed awesome strength. Miller. Winter has played very well as Bruce Winter. They run the ball away from Rowan Hillier to Justin Scanlon. But they can't penetrate the forward line at the moment. Back there is Michael Rennie. He looks set for a good season. He interfered with his opponent on that occasion. Hurt himself a little. And Keith Thomas to take his 11th kick. Lester Ross coming down a long way. Down towards the centre full forward position. Up went Michael Aney. Couldn't take it. Craig Williams is over there as well. Clayton Lamb. And the ball towards the boundary line. Mark Nickham, number 16, was that player. So they have huge strength. Doug Thomas and John Cale leaning forward. He's the perfectionist, John Cale. Button, a good palm. McKinnon, recruited from Mount Gambier. McIntosh, on it goes. The chance for Jarvis. Appeared to be pushed in the back. Oops! Well, there's Herbert. Just vented his frustration a little. And he'd be pretty sore and very tired, I would think. Time starting to run out. Perhaps 8 minutes gone. Andrew Jarvis needs to kick this goal from 45 metres out. It will not be a goal. It's offline and through for a point, and that was a half-back flanker's kick.
Well, Ian, you certainly can't afford to miss those opportunities when Norwood are in this situation. They're 7-10-52, West Adelaide 13-9-87. And there you see umpire Mostyn Rudder officiating in his 200th game, just writing down the score. As Craig Williams and this big crowd here at headquarters thoroughly enjoying this contest. The kickoff, in fact, he's gone over the line, I would assume. Umpire Laurie Argent lining himself up with the wide goal post has declared that Craig Williams has infringed. Kicked over the line and a bounce will take place right on the end of the kickoff line. It'll take place. It'll be put down. Shaw, Button. Button trying to grab the ball, shovels it out. Mark Dreyer is there. And umpire Laurie Argent will call for a further bounce at the end of the kickoff square here at the Lake End at Footy Park.
So with 10 minutes gone in this last quarter, it looks almost certain now that it will be a West Adelaide premiership. There's a shot at goal.
The epic price eater. Cute, huh? But clever. Chomping prices way, way down. There's a feast of savings to be found at Epic. Plus, you'll have the chance to win one of the 6 Weber barbecues complete with a meat pack. Enjoy the feast of savings waiting for you right now at Epic. Skill saws with bonus tungsten carbide saw blade included were $79.99, now only $59.99. Ryobi angle grinder with 100mm blade size was $49.99, now $39.99. Epic building supplies, feast of savings sale. Open 7 days a week. Richmond, Parkside and Salisbury.
Back live with the action as West Adelaide are absolutely powering themselves off. Down in towards the left full forward pocket. Murett must be very close to the best man on the ground, but I think that Dale Woodhull would just about get it. This is his 10th kick coming up from Peter Murett. Right towards the square it goes. Stephen Miller couldn't take it. Heiner's there. They're in plenty of trouble. Conlon's got it. Has a little snap. Won't come back. No, it won't. In actual fact, it'll go out of play on the full and the left full forward pocket.
Bernie Conlon, known as Smurf. Bruce Winter. One of Norwood's better players tonight. He's played a superb game in defence. Kick number 12. Goes to the half-back flank. Big Neil Hine can't take the mark. He should have marked it. Des Herbert pulled off the ball, and a free kick will take place. Des Herbert, who had a scintillating first quarter, and heavy knock in the second quarter, then left the ground. In towards full forward. Tommy Warhurst. Shocks down. Jumper out, as always. Short to Rowan Hellier. Thomas, it's not a good handball. Norden not performing well under pressure. Carl Herbert, number 15. Hellier there. And the umpire will call for a bounce. The umpire is Laurie Asian. Look at that sight. A magnificent night of football here at headquarters. A big crowd. 15,020 people have witnessed a great performance by West Adelaide.
Conlon, taken by Des Herbert. Tackled high, holding the ball, says the umpire. He said, in fact, that Herbert ducked his head into it. So, Taylor, only his fifth kick for the night. What a quiet one. And there's a good mark by Cantor-Lathis. West Adelaide really have been superior tonight. Well, no, the umpire has played it the other way. He's played a push in the back, and the free kick's gone Norwood's way. Keith Thomas has the ball on the outer side. Michael Annie from the side. Fortchard. Grosser, was it, that threaded it towards the boundary? I was saying that Norwood have been well beaten by a far superior side tonight, as Ron Andrews comes onto the ground and Roger Luders leaves it, and this really has been a top performance by the Bloods. Taylor bangs Norwood back to Gallagher, still looks a bit short in his action. That's only his fifth kick. It looks for Button. Fortchard playing in the unaccustomed role of back pocket tonight. Thomas bursts his way clear, slips it over in the direction of Roberts. Doing the mopping up operation was Randall Bennett. Williams comes away with it. Jarvis and McKinnon close to the line. Jarvis controls it well. A diving attempt by McIntosh. Oh, there's a push in the back to Scanlon. It goes unnoticed. The umpire, in fact, has said that Scanlon lay on the ball. McIntosh is not happy. I thought he may have got a 15-metre penalty kick against him, but now Bennett it is who kicks it towards centre wing.
Randall Bennett's kick was not marked by Peter Murett. And Peter Murett mightn't get the man of the match tonight, but by golly, he would certainly get the most skillful player on the ground as Gallagher drives it towards Vow. Danninger couldn't take the mark. On the ground is Button, desperately trying to get it. Cantor-Lathis is there as well. And every team that plays against West Adelaide in season 85 will know they've been playing football at the conclusion of the match. Bernie Conlon having a well-earned drink. Back live with the game. Murett seems to have all the time in the world to do something. Lester Ross, clever play to Justin Scanlon. Norwood work it forward, trying to get it was Roberts, not quite good enough. Michael Aish works his way through. Back it goes. Roberts is there, gets away, gets a little kick in. Interception and taken away by Lamb. Out towards the halfback play. McIntosh bursting through. Normally a left footer, kicks with his right. Fortchard takes the lead.
Fortchard playing on Rocky Roberts for the entire game. Comes to the halfback flank. Randall Bennett, Justin Scanlon. Well, that's the classic catch of the year. Goes to Rowan Hellier. In towards full forward going Norwood. Up goes Roberts. Off hands by Danninger. Can't handle the ball. Dreyer is there. Cantor-Lathis appealing for a holding the ball decision. But umpire Rick Kinnear will call for a bounce. Fan atop there. That's Johnny Cantor-Lathis. Smile on his face. As we see Rocky Roberts get to his feet. Glorious shot here at Football Park. The bounce down. West Adelaide through Filkey, coming towards centre wing. Kick towards the boundary line. Will it fall in play? It does. And there'll be a throw in just in front of the grandstand here at Football Park. Top game of footy. 15,020 people here at Football Park on Nine's Wide World of Sports. Boundary umpire. Shaw. Hine in front to Gallagher. Sat upon by Leon Grosser, and once more the ball out of play.
So almost 15 minutes gone in this final term, and it's going to be a West Adelaide premiership. You can bet your boots on that. Herbert from behind. Gallagher spins out of trouble, does it well. Now where's the handball going? The handball hasn't been good in the last few minutes. McIntosh on his wrong foot again. Roberts on a lead at centre half forward.
flanked by Jarvis. Here's an opportunity for Norwood as Jarvis' kick has been smothered. Into the pocket it goes. Bardenega. Williams hold. An umpire can hear the sides on a bounce. And there's Jeff Morris, who started the match on the ground and then went to the interchange bench. And he's warming up to come back on again. Meanwhile, the action's on the outer side and umpire Argent has paid a free kick. It will go West Adelaide's way. Carl Herbert gives it to Cantalaftis. Almost ran himself into trouble. Hellier from behind, not paid. Hamilton. Bennett, been a very fine player for West Adelaide. And there's Herbert, who was a star in that first quarter. Got a heavy knock, and he's back in the action again. Hamilton had a good duel with McIntosh. Perhaps the honours with McIntosh. Grosser shrugs the tackle. Short, looks for Woodall. He's booted eight. Can't take that one. Out it comes. Warhurst. Michael Taylor ducks ahead. Through he goes. Roll tackle. And that's good umpiring, allowing the play to go on until finally he picks out a free kick. And it's gone West Adelaide's way at centre-half forward.
Jeff Morris warming up. Forward goes the ball, and Cantalaftis, who has come a long way down ground, normally plays in the back pocket. This will be kick number 13 for John Cantalaftis. Long kick goes in towards the square, won't make the distance. Bruce Winter is up there, couldn't take the mark. 17 minutes have gone in the grand final. 4 minutes plus time on Ronnie Andrews.
Dying moments of the final quarter as Roberts has a boot for goal and kicks it through. Well, Norwood get their ninth. It came from Roberts. That's his fourth. It's a belated goal, but Rick Davies, Norwood now are gone.
Yes, I think the powerful machine of the West Adelaide side, let's face it, we've said it all night, they're going to be a very, very hard side to beat. And they've proved it tonight, not only with their tackling, but with their shooting up forward. Woodhall with 7 or 8 goals. But then again, the old fella's done a magnificent job there in kicking 4. So they've tried all night.
29 points the difference as Shaw went up there, taken by Aish. Clever footballer over to McIntosh, who's kept on battling on, taken by Jarvis. Long kick forward. Norwood try to work the ball effectively into their forward line, but it's Michael Rennie picking it up. Bennett's played very well. Randall Bennett's a very skillful footballer. In fact, that was his 15th use of the ball, taken here by Rennie. Rennie down towards the right half forward flank, and you really must pay a tribute to this man. He was knocked very heavily. He was looked to be a little concussed, but he's got up and he's got on with it. He's driven the ball right towards the full forward position, but the free kick will be taken back by Michael Taylor. What a super footballer Michael Taylor is. I was just about to say has been. Well, of course he's not, because he's got still 2 or 3 years ahead of him, and I'm sure that he will give his best. Down towards the centre position it goes. Over the top as it's taken through by Lester Ross towards Roberts, who's booted 4. Well done, Ian Borchard. You have played well tonight. Very quickly, Cantalaftis away towards Rennie. This is a good half back line, a very strong back line from West Adelaide. They have strength, power and persistency all over the ground. Richard Hamilton, who averages 30 touches every game he plays in, down towards the centre half forward position. Rowan Hellier took it away, goes Murette. Tackle, but the whistle is gone, and the umpire is going to award a free kick or a mark to Rowan Hellier.
Yes, I think he paid the mark, Ian. Winter drives long. Greg Thomas on his own. Well shepherded. Now he's got an open space. In the pocket. Drives towards the square. Scanlon from behind. Here's a chance for Scanlon. 1 point.
Good work there by the West Adelaide defence. They have been superb tonight, the West Adelaide defence. They haven't let a thing go past without Norwood making the best of their opportunities.
Craig Williams. Well, not a lot of pressure applied on that occasion when he's able to kick to himself and then touch the ground. Give it to Cantalaftis. Cantalaftis around the outer side of the oval, couldn't take the mark. Bardaniga's over there. Played very well, Glenn Bardaniga. Number 41 is kick 2. Here's the chance for Greg Thomas. Back it goes. Held without possession of the ball or taking too long to get rid of it. Randall Bennett will take the free kick for West Adelaide. Just about to go into the time on period, and it's going to be $30,000. What a mark! What a beautiful leap there from Stephen Miller. High over the top, the youngster. Very lanky footballer, a very skillful player. Down towards the centre full forward position. Barmer's there. Back it goes to Herbert. In turn to Carl Herbert. That was Des Herbert that gave it forward first. Bruce Winter there. On to Michael Ace, who's tackled quickly. Free kick, and your commentator will be David Darcy.
A very tired Norwood side, as Neil Barm and Glenn Ross are obviously very disappointed with their display tonight. West Adelaide too persistent, too strong, too fast, all over the ground. Gallagher to Jarvis. Now the umpire's picked out something. I can't believe what that one is. Throwing the ball, was it, Rick?
Well, I think that Ronnie Andrews grabbed him by the arm. And as he went through to do the handball, it slipped out the end. And, of course, the umpire was right on the scene.
Well, the free has gone the way of Ron Andrews. He's got it about 45 metres out. A torpedo punt will not go the full distance. Hall has front position and the big fella takes the mark. Almost got his head pulled off. Michael Ace had a wonderful game for Norwood. 16 kicks and 11 handballs. Bennett for West Adelaide, 15 kicks and 8 handballs, has played an exceptional game. But probably Dale Woodhall, with his 8 goals, will be the man of the match tonight. We'll wait on that decision. That will be given to you after the final siren. Vardeniger takes it for Norwood. Scanlon runs into the open goal. He's going to be caught, but he still gets his kick. And Scanlon has kicked Norwood's 10th goal and his first. Rick Davies.
Yes, well, even though that Scanlon was out in the open there, the West Adelaide still managed to grab him by the Guernsey and put him under a little bit of pressure, although the ball came down there very quickly. As we see here on the replay, the ball shot out there by Michael Annie, trapped by Vardeniger. He gets the handball over to Scanlon, shoots away, see the fella there, the West Adelaide player in Rennie, still manages to get his glove on him, but he's the goal comes up.
2 minutes into the time on now. 22 points the difference. It's West Adelaide, okay. John Hall to Aish. Aish kicking down towards the centre half forward position. Scanlon there, and so has Rennie. Been very impressed with Michael Rennie's performance tonight, and he's been well supported by Lamb. Back it goes, looking for Grosser. Grosser seconds McGarry, medalist. Away he goes, kicks the ball down towards the centre half forward position. Can't get it. Conlon there, tackles his opponent, and Jarvis. And Conlon felt that he would have liked to have got that. In the dying stages of the Escort Cup Championship, as out it goes to Craig Barm. Finds Taylor, McIntosh. McIntosh to Greg Thomas, and Norwood worked the ball forward. They must be commended for the way that they've kept on keeping on. They've not given up one little bit, and it's taken by Shaw. Shaw out towards the outer side of the oval looking for Lamb, and Lamb has taken the mark.
So we've played 3 minutes of time on in this final quarter, and the Escort Cup will rest safely in the West Adelaide club rooms. And there's a very elated, I would think, John Cale, having come back to South Australia in his very first encounter winning a premiership. Oh, she's on. Hall and Andrews. Here we go. Where's Jacko? She's on the other side of the ground now. Common sense should prevail here. Umpire Kinnear comes in to settle them down. John Cale's happy. He's won. He's not interested in proceedings over there. So a great performance that by West Adelaide. And Neil Barm is a dejected man. West Adelaide have won the 1985 Escort Cup 14-9, defeating Norwood 10-11. We'll take a break and then come back here to Football Park in just a moment.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm certain you'll agree with me. We've just seen a magnificent final of the 1985 Escort Cup.
A tremendous performance by both sides, West Adelaide and Norwood. It is indeed my pleasure to call upon the President of the South Australian National Football League, Mr. Max Bashir, to make the necessary presentations. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Max Bashir.
Thank you very much, Ken. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to thank you very much for your support for the Escort series, and we look forward to your support for the coming season. It's obviously going to be a great season, and I'd like to think that you'll come back in your numbers to watch these great teams play. I want to thank all of the league clubs for their cooperation during this series.
I just hope that you're soaking up the atmosphere of this game as we are here at Football Park. A tremendous sight, tremendous crowd, great atmosphere, and a great game on our hands. 8-6 at halftime, West Adelaide leading Norwood 5-5. And the winner of tonight's game, grand final, will receive $30,000, including a trophy, and to the loser goes $20,000. Plus, there'll be a $500 Man of the Match award, and that will be announced after the game has been completed here tonight.
And a very quick one, Rick, at this stage of the game, who would be your Man of the Match?
Well, I think that Clayton Lamb on the halfback flank, or Dale Woodhall up forward. He's kicked five goals. He's had a couple of easy ones, but Clayton Lamb has done a superb job on the halfback flank.
David Payne, the young Norwood rover, half forward, has also been in the thick of things. He's contributed well too, Ian.
Yes, he has, and he's playing in his second year of football.
So the action about to start at the third quarter, with just 19 points separating the two sides. And what a crackerjack game we saw in the first half. There's number 26 for West Adelaide, Stephen Miller. And the Bloods are straight into attack. Aishu lifted in that second quarter. Keith Thomas. Gallagher looks a little short in his action. Goes out wide, looking for that man I was talking about just a few moments ago, Payne, the talented Vardaniga. Around Rennie, although Rennie finally lays a hand on him. The pass is short, and it's successful. We'll just wait and see who it is. Some a player in trouble. It is David Payne, and he has hurt himself diving for that ball. And Gary McIntosh will take the free kick.
Das, I think that big Mark Dreyer ran in and just sort of couldn't stop himself there. I think he just ran into the back of him.
So Payne's still injured. He's being treated by the trainer. As McIntosh goes long, looking for Michael Annie. Chance for Grosser. Vardaniga. Grosser close to the line. Gets a kick back. But the boundary umpire signifies that the ball is out of play. And we've been playing for just 1 minute in the third quarter. And still 19 points separating the two sides.
Yes, three goals, one the difference. And David Payne has still not moved as the ball will go into the area that David Payne is in. They've got him up on his feet now. A little chap's up, but for the moment, Shaw kicks the ball right from where David Payne is. Over the top of the Lester Ross. Chance now for Norwood to move it to Gallagher, who looks a bit stiff and jumpy in his movements. Out it came to Bennett and turn. Chance now for Filkey. Filkey kicking forward underneath it, and there's a good mark to Bruce Winter. Bruce Winter really is a fine footballer. Started with Sturt, plays for Norwood, over towards Scanlon, very close to the boundary line and out of play.
There's Payne, who's still in a bit of pain, pardon the pun. John Hall, 37. 15 for West Adelaide is Carl Herbert. Scanlon tackles him. Umpire Argent in for the bounce. So still the scores at 19 points the difference. Michael Aish had 13 possessions in the first half. Michael Taylor was a bit quiet. McIntosh was the ever-reliable McIntosh. Stephen Miller. Now Jarvis. Jarvis. Miller gets it out wide. Warhurst. Keith Thomas. Thomas, who had four kicks and five handballs in that first half, goes back towards the centre of the ground. Oh, Michael Annie was held with that the ball, and he'll take the free kick.
Jim Michael Annie takes full use of his 15 metres. Down to Roberts. That's a good capture. That's a strong mark for Neville Roberts. So far in the game,
Number nine for Norwood, Neville Roberts, their captain, has kicked a goal. Now he's about 45 metres out from goals. Anything up to 40 metres, he would be the straightest kick in Australia. He doesn't chance his length, and he fended it off to Keith Thomas. And now Keith Thomas. No one on his mark. Long penetrating kick. It's got the distance, and it can't get much closer than that. It's hit the post.
Well, bad luck there for Norwood. Neville Roberts took the great mark. He passed it off to the Norwood player there in Thomas, and unfortunately hit the post.
The outer side go West Adelaide. Grosser gets out of trouble. He has Dreher short at centre-half back. Dreher in turn has Cantor-Lastis on a long lead. Well, here's a build-up for West Adelaide. Loses Muret. That's ignored. Dreher instead gives support. Luders. Randall Bennett. Run a long way, an awful long way, and he's kicked a long way, and he's kicked magnificently! A goal, a great goal!
What a magnificent goal there from West Adelaide. Going out onto the left foot in Bennett, shooting directly at the front of goal. Here we see it on the Channel 9 screen, over there to Luders. He handballs quickly to Bennett, shapes up, runs around the mark, fires it into the open goal and brings up his second goal.
Back live as Neil Button comes onto the ground. Norwood now move the ball through Michael Aney to McIntosh. McIntosh to Ace. Ace driving the ball right in towards the square with his tenth kick. No one can get it except Roberts. Roberts has a snap at the goal. Remarkably kicks it out of play on the full under intense pressure.
Coming out after half-time, I know how he feels. He'd be a little bit stiff. Most of the Norwood players would be. And here it comes, punched away, down to Roberts. Snapped, but unfortunately caught the outer side and went out of bounds on the full.
Lester Ross drives Norwood back into attack. Roberts in trouble. Borchardt takes it, goes short to Bennett. Now let's go back to Neville Roberts. He's laid prostrate on the ground at centre-half forward. The trainers are now getting to him. But really, as he flew for that ball, he got tangled up in that pack and is in trouble. Neil Balm's in trouble and Norwood are in trouble. Roberts still hasn't moved. On trainer signalling for a stretcher, or is it from the doctor? Meanwhile, the action is at the other end of the ground where Filkey has it for West Adelaide. Filkey kicks it long, but the umpire's seen an infringement. It's going against West Adelaide. And it's going Norwood's way, and it'll be taken by Michael Ace. So this will be his 11th kick. And Roberts is on his feet. That's good news. But by golly, he still looks a bit groggy. Michael Annie from behind, Rennie from the front. And Michael Annie's been paid.
Well, it's going to go into the forward area. Button using his body and brute strength. But a little excessive brute strength. And the free kick goes the way of Williams. The former All-Australian kicks back towards the centre wing. Michael Aney up. Couldn't take the mark because Lester Ross is there. And the little back pocket player a long way from home. Down towards the left half forward flank. They set themselves. Vardeniger out to McIntosh. Clever play by McIntosh. Oh, good football. Here's the opportunity for Vardeniger. Lines up the goals and shoots it through for 1 point.
Yes, well, there's also bad luck from Norwood. They're not having much luck at the moment. They're just chipping away. West Adelaide got a good start, and they're starting to sort of just chip away and see if they can get back into this game.
23 points of difference as Michael Lanny marks the kick in. Now, he's a good 60 metres out. The distance will probably be too far for him, although he goes back an extra couple of yards. Very straight leg, very good timing. Towards centre full forward area, Button couldn't mark it. The West Adelaide defence is firm. Muret's loose. So's Filkey. Filkey with exhilarating pace. Burst through the centre. Kicks long towards centre half forward. But there's a great mark taken in defence by Rowan Hallier. Herbert was in there like a little bloodhound. But Hallier just pushed him aside. Taylor, who I believe is now playing in the back pocket. Filkey's over the mark. There must be a 15-metre penalty.
Gus, I think that West Adelaide, every time the ball gets into the half forward plate, they run in and they give a free away. They not only give a free away on the grandstand side, but I've noticed they've done it every time the ball gets into the attack of in the defence of Norwood.
Well, it is delaying the progress of the side trying to get out of defence, and it looks as though it's a set plan set up by Carr. The free has gone the way of Shaw, and West Adelaide, who lead by 23 points, as Philip Gallagher leaves the field, go forward again. Filkey has it at centre wing, and the commentator is Ian Aitken.
8 minutes into the third quarter, number 10 was the kick to Filkey towards Miller. Miller takes a good mark at centre half forward. Herbert signalling he wants it, but it's down towards Woodall. Couldn't take the mark on the ground. It's Carl Herbert, tried to scoop it away. Big John Hall and turned to Fantasia onto Greg Thomas. The tackling and pressure is fierce as Murett bursts through the pack, lines up the goals and bangs it through for 1 point.
Well, they're the goals that Murett, with his brilliance, ball-getting ability, should have made dead sure of that one and let sort of Norwood come back a little bit.
Winter to the outer side, looking for Hall and finds him. So four straight kicks in the game. Norwood have added 2 points in this third quarter. West Adelaide 1-1. Button had front position. Lamb, who played brilliantly in the first half, heads for Cantalaftis. Over the top goes Cantalaftis. Here's an opportunity now for Conlon. Bernie Conlon boots it towards centre half forward. Oh, but it's all Norwood in the way. And John Hall takes the defensive mark. He lays it off to Scanlon. Scanlon in turn to Winter. Keith Thomas on a long lead, and that's a good pass from Bruce Winter. Thomas wastes no time, but the kick is very high. Ace has front position, off courage. Lost his head in the process, but by geez, a great player, and what courage he shows.
Well, when the going gets tough, the tough get going, and this is what a great little player Michael Ace is, and he needs to too, because Norwood in a little bit of trouble here. He needs to really get his act together and see if he can start them going.
As West Adelaide move it away through Dreer, Michael Ace to support Rick Davies has had 12 kicks in the game so far. John Hall to Michael Taylor, who's starting to come back into some good touch. Lester Ross was tackled rather high and out of play. John Cale looking on very pensively. The professional coach went to Collingwood as full-time coach. Lester Ross got it. Looks for support and Michael Taylor. Hamilton in trouble. Well, it's good to see that Herbert's okay. Hamilton boots it off the ground looking for Luders. McKinnon bursting through. A long half pass to Filkey. Filkey forced to kick with his left foot and is not accurate and gets through for 1 point.
Well, Norwood putting a little bit more pressure on the West Adelaide forwards now. That lady would be feeling a lot better because that one missed. But Norwood are starting to chip away now. They're starting to relax themselves and get back into this game.
Scanlon. Can Norwood fight back? Scanlon has it in the back pocket. The difference is 25 points. It was 19 at half time. Lamb. Scanlon trying very hard. Michael Taylor shifted to the back pocket. Fantasia now. And Norwood out of trouble towards centre wing. Micken and Michael Annie. Dreyer goes in strongly, as does Michael Ace. Now, where's the support? Here it is from Vardaniga. Vardaniga's kick only covers about 8 metres. Thomas had the front position. That's Keith Thomas. The handball's out wide to Lachlan. Dreyer trying to burst his way through, couldn't. And finally, players stack up, and there'll be a bounce. So 11, almost 12 minutes gone in this third quarter. And 5-7 Norwood play West Adelaide 9-8.
21-minute quarters in the third and fourth quarter, plus time on, as Keith Thomas to Fantasia. Norwood worked the ball down around the outer side of the oval, in fact, very close to the outer side, as it's picked up by their captain in West Adelaide's captain in Borchard. Rennie grabbed and grabbed very quickly, but out of play is the ball. Michael Rennie, number 36, a very, very big crowd. And it has been and is a superb night of football, as Michael Aney does well for Lachlan to get into the action. McIntosh in turn back to Michael Aney to Thomas. Good use of handball here. Fantasia tries one too many. Conlon takes possession of the ball and drives it down towards the centre half forward position. Players up, players down. Luders and Bruce Winter. Oh, he's as cool as a cucumber as Bruce Winter. Always does something reliable. Vardaniga kicked a couple. Carl Herbert has possession for Westies. The Bloods go forward, down taken by Murette. Mr. Immaculate, the Looters, who heard the call from Woodall, and Woodall, who in the first half booted five and has now got the opportunity to make it six.
Very relaxed player is Woodall. He seems to wait back into the square, makes a short lead, and the West Adelaide players up forward, the Murettes, the players there, magnificent.
Well, Woodall, West Adelaide at half-time rate, six now, they're 9-8. So they've kicked one goal, two prior to that kick from Dale Woodall, and that's his sixth.
Six goals to Dale Woodall. Well, let's face it, he's been the forward that's, well, he's won the game. Let's face it, as I said before, waits in the square, makes the short lead, and then what makes a very, very good full forward, he's a very straight kick.
It was Carl Herbert that had it. Now watch Luders. Murette takes it, he sees Luders on the lead, called out by Woodall, and Luders responded well. Woodall has booted six, and West Adelaide 10-6 lead Norwood 5-7.
Michael Aish again drives Norwood out of the square, down towards the full forward position. Roberts on the bottom of the pack there, Button there to give support, and Neville Roberts, Neil Baum. Oh, well, he should shrug his head. Roberts in a bit of trouble. Back with the action. Ketalaftis going in there trying to get it. Hasn't got it yet, but he's good enough to knock it away. Lachlan in trouble. A long hand pass back to Fantasia. Not knowing what to do with it because the pressure's intense. Back it came to Lachlan, to Thomas. And now Thomas, too far to score, doesn't try. McIntosh, and McIntosh takes it. Back with Roberts. Looks as though he could have a bit of cramp, or he seems okay now. And Craig McIntosh, who has had, this will be his eighth kick, and they need this goal from McIntosh. The distance is okay, and the accuracy is going to be not quite good enough. 1 point.
Well, McIntosh there, as they Norwood, as we looked at Big Barmy there, he'd be worrying what he could do up forward, but unfortunately, the West Adelaide defence is just far too strong.
Rennie, Williams support. Well, they're fiddling around here. Button after them, but Rennie gets clear. West Adelaide towards centre wing. Outer side. Clayton Lamb up and takes a good mark. Boy, he's played well, Clayton Lamb. And West Adelaide now move it forward. Dreyer kicks towards centre half forward. Picked up cleverly by Luders. They can see ground, but retain possession as Bennett bangs it in towards the square. Hallier from behind. Hits it clear. Puts it out of play. So almost 16 minutes gone in this third quarter. The Escort Cup Grand Final is Barry Downs, the team manager of West Adelaide, and Leon Grosser comes off the interchange bench. Keith Thomas has it for Norwood at the other end of the ground. Bruce Winter comes clear. Now he really has kicked well tonight, Winter. Looking out wide for Vardeninger. With him, Lamb. Oh, he pulled on the arm of Vardeninger, unseen by the umpire. Lamb gives it to Bennett. Bennett goes in short, looking for Murette in the pocket, and finds him. Brilliant football again by West Adelaide. And the Bloods are really going to be a threat in 85. Mark my words. Murette's back. The last time he played with the club, they won a grand final. And will history repeat itself? This will be his seventh kick. Peter Murette has not kicked a goal to date. And if he bangs this one through, they'll go six goals clear. It's on its way. It's a drop punt. It's a terrific kick. A goal to Murette. And West Adelaide, 11-8, lead Norwood 5-8.
Well, Peter Murette's lost nothing from going up to Broken Hill. I thought that Vandeniger had the open run out on the outer side. But to Clayton Lamb, who's been my best man on the ground, you can see this, handballs it over to Bennett. He swings the ball around. And watch Murette position himself over the top, watching the ball. And it wouldn't be easy out there, I'll tell you. And goes back and kicks a magnificent goal.
It was a beaut kick, wasn't it? As Hamilton gets it across. But McIntosh intercepts and does it very well. Norwood really need to run on, and run on very quickly. Fantasia driving the ball down to Roberts. Roberts, who's in plenty of trouble so far, takes the mark. Neville Roberts, been told to play on. Ball to the ground, and Westies come right over the top. Norwood are in plenty of trouble at the moment. They were trailing at half-time by 19 points. They don't really look as though they're doing it well enough. Rick Davies said West Adelaide are a very scrappy side. I wonder if he'd like to still stick with that opinion.
But when I say scrappy, and I mean that they're at the player, they're at the ball. Scrappy is a funny word, but they're always make it hard for the opposition.
But Roberts! Oh, that's a superb mark. Fantastic mark, Neville Roberts. He's been knocked to the ground, he's had cramp, and he still finds the energy and the courage to fly over the pack. And let's have a look at that. Oh, fantastic mark, Roberts. So if ever Norwood needed Neville Roberts to boot a goal for them, they do now. They trail by 6 goals. This will reduce it to 5. 15 metres out. Does he miss those? No, he doesn't. That's his second.
Well, what a magnificent mark there by Neville Roberts. And let's face it, what would Neil Baum be thinking? What could he possibly do? There he is. What could he do? He's moved Big Button to full forward. He's had Michael Annie at centre-half forward. His main strike rate is Neville Roberts. He must fire for Norwood to win the game. And what a magnificent captain's effort that was to kick a much-needed goal.
And Neville Roberts is virtually on one leg at the moment. But I think Neville Roberts, even on one leg, is still a superb footballer. As Norwood now, knowing that they're in trouble, McIntosh bursting out of the centre, but well tackled and tackled by Hamilton, who recovers brilliantly, drives it down to Murett, who is emerging as the most effective player on the field, down in towards the forward pocket. Bruce Winter, a superb game in defence and does it all the time. Up over the top of Stephen Miller, a beautiful mark. Miller, rangy, over 6 foot, only 22 years of age. A beautiful kicker of the ball, and he drives it right in towards the square. Off hands it comes. The chance for Luders. Luders playing in a forward pocket, but the goal umpire has signalled that the ball was rushed through for 1 point.
The value of the fresh player coming on there at half-time. Young Miller, fresh legs, came right over the top there to take a great mark.
Winter goes short. Met solidly was Greg Thomas, but fairly. He has it at centre half back. Nobody's standing his mark, so he's off. Grandstand side. Keith Thomas. Michael Annie in the middle of the pack, and he takes it. Well, Jim Michael Annie at centre wing, flanked by Jarvis. Pretty quiet one in tonight, Jarvis. A high kick looks for Button. Roberts is there also. Cantor left us the crumbs. Does the mopping up operation. West Adelaide through Rennie get clear towards centre wing. It's too long for Michael Annie. Jarvis in close with him, does the shepherding, but Michael Annie walks the ball, in fact, over the line and out of play. So 20 minutes gone in this third quarter, remembering, of course, that the third quarter is 21 minutes plus time on. So is the last quarter. And if we're going to have an exciting finish, then Nord really have to get on with this business and get on with it quickly to get back in the game. They're trying valiantly, but every attempt that they make is being met head-on by West Adelaide. As Hamilton kicks his ninth kick towards centre-half forward, Jarvis had front position, Warhurst run down, in the back says the umpire, and terrific Tom takes it at centre-half back.
Well, Norwood to me looks starting to be a little bit tired here. They're starting to run a little bit slower, in my opinion, and West Adelaide, well, they'll be the fittest side in the competition. They seem to be running on.
Those comments came to you from Rick Davies as West Adelaide scooped the ball through the centre of the ground, kicking down towards centre-half forward. Luders over the top, couldn't take it. McKinnon does and does it very well. On it goes to Des Herbert. Murett's the danger man, pokes it out the front, and this will be goal number 7 to Dale Woodall, and he would be the best man on the ground tonight as he kicked the ball right out of the football park arena.
Well, how easy can you get it? Dale Woodall, not a big player, I thought he was bigger than that. Luders, renowned for a big jump, puts it over the top to Herbert. He in turn, with his left hand, you watch Murett, draws the player. How easy is it?
Rick, they're so quick and so strong, West Adelaide, at the moment. Did you see McKinnon just burst through that pack? He's only 5'10".
Well, as I said before, Dust, scrappy play. See, they're winning it easy.
At the bounce, Greg Thomas takes it for the Redlegs. Forward they go. Keith Thomas, Cantalaftis, controls the ball beautifully. Forced onto his left foot. Grosser. In trouble, Carl Herbert. Michael Taylor. Lester Ross. It's
wait on the umpire. He's picked a free kick out. It's going to Lester Ross for a push. And he's got it at centre wing. No, it's going back to Greg Thomas. Now Greg Thomas now goes long, looking for Michael Annie. Dreher had front position. And umpire Arjun has sorted out another free kick. And again, it's going to Norwood. And this time it's Jim Michael Annie. Well, he's within range as John Carl comes down to the ground level. Michael Annie, instead of kicking long, saw Roberts on a lead. And the Rock has it at centre half forward. Ian Aitken told you a few moments ago that from within 40 metres, he's the best shot for goal in Australia. He still agrees, still says that he's right. Let's watch Roberts. I agree with you, Ian. Well, I bet you he lets us both down. No, he hasn't. He is the best kick in Australia from 40 metres, and Roberts has booted his third.
Well, Michael Andy's done a fantastic job wherever he's played, whether it be centre-half forward or on the half-forward flank. And he's taken about five or six marks there, and he's passed the ball off magnificently to Roberts. And to the old warhorse's credit, he's kicked another goal.
So there it is. Three-quarter time at Football Park in the grand final of the Escort Cup. Norwood 7-8-50, trial West Adelaide 12-9. We'll take a break and then come back with the last quarter. Three-quarter time in the grand final of the Escort Cup, and West Adelaide 12-9 lead Norwood 7-8. Ken, the question on everybody's mind is, can the Norwood side come back?
Well, David, I believe they can. You never ever say that Norwood are gone at three-quarter time. Of course, they're five goals down, but there were signs there that the Norwood were coming back. But take nothing away from West Adelaide. Each time that Norwood has got that step closer, the Bloods have broken away. But Ian, I believe Norwood can come back. I really believe that Norwood have been absolutely astounded by West Adelaide's vigour and their aggression tonight.
Well, Norwood have the ability to come back, but whether they can do it tonight, I don't know, because West Adelaide in that third quarter booted four and Norwood were only able to boot two. Neil Baum is in there. He certainly believes that these players can come back and win it. He's a very, very exalted coach, and he's a fine coach. There's no doubt about that. And this is just one of the other sides of Neil Baum that we don't often see too much about. And if you can lip read, well, you might be able to understand what he said. I did.
Not happy. What a character. A quiet man in the rooms and around the ground, but they tell me, Kim, when he sits on the bench, as we saw, there goes berserk.
Well, you're right there. He gets his point over to his players. He's a well-respected coach, but it's going to take all of Baum's magic in this last quarter. They are going with the breeze, but it will take all of Baum's magic to get them back. But, David, I have never, ever seen a West Adelaide side so aggressive and at the same time use the football so superbly.
Their pace, their strength, their skills are fantastic. And I just can't see, I don't think I've ever seen a better West Adelaide side than the performance we've seen tonight, particularly that first quarter when they were absolutely electrifying. I don't see any side at the moment from the size that we've seen in the Escort Cup getting close to West Adelaide.
Are you surprised, David, they are so aggressive when, okay, the last two or three years they've been coached by probably the strongest coach for many, many years, Neil Curley? I didn't believe they could find so much aggression.
Well, I think it's probably the experience that John Carl's had in Victoria. I hate to say that, but I really think that is the reason, Ian.
Well, yes, I think that's a fair point, but I think there's one other thing that they are doing. They are applying enormous pressure.
Well, they are indeed, and can Norwood come back? That's the big question to be answered in the last 21 minutes plus time on. We'll take a break now and then come back to show you that last quarter.
When you buy a new car, price is a major consideration, and that's why we're extending our 1,066 cashback offer on new Sigma and Colt.
Welcome back to Football Park. West Adelaide 12-9, leading Norwood 7-8. Umpire Argent has the ball in his hand. Players about to start in the last quarter. Five goals, one the difference. To take you to the action, Ian Aitken.
Well, this is it. You either win 30,000 or you win 20,000. But the winner will get the 30 as immediately West Adelaide go forward through Conlon. Back there is Rowan Hellyer, one of the exciting youngsters at Norwood, as Lester Ross is in flight. Can't control the ball, it's taken away from him, but to infringement. And Carl Herbert was the offender. Number 15, Lester Ross number 10. 21 minutes plus time on. Justin Scanlon. And the Norwood players looking a little weary. There's down ground that goes to Michael Aish. He's had a good game, Michael Aish. Had a superb game last week. Looking to give it to McIntosh. McIntosh has been a little quiet in the last couple of weeks. Back it goes to Aish in turn towards centre full forward. Michael Aney up behind. There's a good mark. The umpire is not going to pay it to Shaw. He's going to give it to Michael Aney by the look of it. No, he's not. He takes the easy way out and bounces.
Well, I can't believe that. It was Michael Aney's mark for Shaw. Umpire Rick Kinnear will call for a further bounce down, but gee whiz, I was always told the golden rule was to pay the man in front, and that was Jim Michael Aney on that occasion. The bounce. Candelaptis back towards centre half back. Stephen Miller out to the half back flank. Lester Ross is there, number 10. He's full of courage. Overruns the ball, butters up again. Scrambling football as players throw their body over the ball. Stephen Miller is there, and Craig Barnes got his head in his hand again. I reckon he's aged about 20 years tonight, Barmy. He's really given those chills a thrashing. McIntosh comes away with the ball, tries to draw the player, goes onto his right foot into the pocket, but back there is Clayton Lamb.
Clayton Lamb, who's played a superb game in defence for the Bloods, kicks him clear towards centre wing. From behind it was Miller, Filkey, Randall Bennett. Gee, Bennett's played well also. Bennett had 12 kicks and 6 handballs to three-quarter time. Now Norwood go forward from Keith Thomas. The big bear button in front, can't mark it. Chance for Scanlon, pops it over the top. Here's a go for Roberts. Oh, he hurried that one, just too much. Not enough talking from the players around Neville Roberts. Hurried the shot and missed.
Very unusual to see Neville Roberts do that. It's Craig Williams. Drives the ball towards centre half-back. Knocked on very cleverly by Muret. He really is a brilliant player. Grant Filkey has tremendous speed. Down towards Ludus, couldn't find him. Taken by Winter. Best man on the ground tonight gets $500. It's not going to be easy either to judge that best man on the ground. Number 31 is Jim Michael Aney. West Adelaide at the moment look as though they have it in their control. It's 30 points the difference. But I still say that Norwood have got the ability to come back and win this game as Carl Herbert kicks down in towards the full forward position. Oh, Bruce Winter, you really are a champion. There is no doubt about that. He's played an absolute magnificent game. This will be his 10th kick as he comes down looking for McIntosh. McIntosh met very heavily, but he's rough, tough, and not terribly handsome.
Oh, he loves it tough, McIntosh. He really does. Comes away towards Jarvis. His kick to the half-forward flank. Var Danning is there. He's played pretty well tonight. Muret, number 10. Rowan Hellyer. Muret, look at that handball. Fantastic football. Back to Johnny Candelaptis. Very cool, calm and collected. Sells the dummy. Goes towards the half-forward line. Stephen Miller. Short, shocking kick. Richard Hamilton. In towards centre-half forward. Luders up high. Ball to ground. Body, vigorous football. Michael Taylor. Over to Craig Barm. Barm. Keith Thomas, Norwood working the ball out of defence. Runs through centre half, back in towards centre. The poor kick, and Dreher is back there, and he'll take the mark.
Dreher slips it to Muret. West Adelaide forward again. Muret has a bounce, now goes long. In look, oh, what a magnificent kick from Muret. From the moment it left his boot, it was going to find its mark. And that mark, of course, is Dale Woodhall. And there's a 15-metre, and that's ridiculous football from Craig Barm. A 15-metre penalty against him has brought Woodhall to them, in fact, 40 to the line. Now, he can't miss from here. He's already booted at 7, and there's Neil Barm, who's most disgusted, I'm sure, with that performance. 8 to Woodhall. And West Adelaide are 13-9, Norwood 7-9.
Well, We've still got time to go. It's nearly 5 minutes. In fact, it is 5 minutes have gone in the game. And that might be just about the best man on the ground, either Woodall or Murett. And isn't he a classy footballer? He went back to Broken Hill where he was born. He started his career at Woodville, remarkably. They swapped him with Ken Deards, West Adelaide. And a little bit of help there.
Michael Aish. What an outstanding performance has been by West Adelaide. 13-9, 87, Norwood 7-9, 51. Umpire Rick Kinnear, one of the senior umpires in South Australia in this game, coming to you on Nine's Wide World of Sports.
Richard Hamilton takes it away from the centre for the Bloods once more. 10th kick by Hamilton. Carl Herbert on his wrong foot. Kicks high towards centre half forward. Oh, courage again from Winter, backing into the ball. Or running with the ball, backing into the play. And Winter comes grandstand side. Aish, who had 21 possessions to three-quarter time, has been paid the mark a little fortuitously. And this will be his 15th kick. 8 handballs included. Mickham from behind. Keith Thomas, the clever Keith Thomas. Gallagher's had a quiet one. Out wide. Bad handball. And West Adelaide are strong and determined. Rennie typifies that. So does Filkey. Cantalapis making space on the left foot. Bangs it in towards the pocket. 10 kicks to Cantalapis. That one's not well directed. Carl Herbert can't get to it. And it's out of play. 15,020 people here to witness the grand final of the Escort Cup.
And it really has been a spectacular game of football. Rough, tough, not always pretty. But West Adelaide have displayed awesome strength. Miller. Winter has played very well as Bruce Winter. They run the ball away from Rowan Hillier to Justin Scanlon, but they can't penetrate the forward line at the moment. Back there is Michael Rennie. He looks set for a good season. He interfered with his opponent on that occasion, hurt himself a little. And Keith Thomas to take his 11th kick. Lester Ross coming down a long way. Down towards the centre full forward position. Up went Michael Aney, couldn't take it. Craig Williams is over there as well. Clayton Lamb. And the ball towards the boundary line. Mark Nickham, number 16, was that player. So they have huge strength. Doug Thomas and John Cale leaning forward. He's the perfectionist, John Cale. Button, a good palm. McKinnon, recruited from Mount Gambier. McIntosh. On it goes, the chance for Jarvis. Appeared to be pushed in the back. Oops! Well, there's Herbert. Just vented his frustration a little. And he'd be pretty sore and very tired, I would think. Time starting to run out. Perhaps 8 minutes gone. Andrew Jarvis needs to kick this goal from 45 metres out. It will not be a goal. It's offline and through for a point, and that was a half-back flanker's kick.
Well, Ian, you certainly can't afford to miss those opportunities when Norwood are in this situation. They're 7-10-52, West Adelaide 13-9-87. And there you see umpire Mostyn Rudder officiating in his 200th game, just writing down the score. There's Craig Williams and this big crowd here at headquarters thoroughly enjoying this contest. The kick-off. In fact, he's gone over the line, I would assume. Umpire Laurie Argent lining himself up with the white goal post has declared that Craig Williams has infringed. Kicked over the line, and a bounce will take place right on the end of the kickoff line. It'll take place. It'll be put down. Shaw, Button. Button trying to grab the ball, shovels it out. Mark Dreyer is there. And umpire Laurie Argent will call for a further bounce at the end of the kickoff square here at the Lake End at Footy Park.
So with 10 minutes gone in this last quarter, it looks almost certain now that it will be a West Adelaide premiership. There's a shot at goal. And it's through. Goal to Glenn Vardenigan.
The Epic Price Eater. Cute, huh? But clever. Chomping prices way, way down. There's a feast of savings to be found at Epic. Plus, you'll have the chance to win one of the 6 Weber barbecues complete with a meat pack. Enjoy the feast of savings waiting for you right now at Epic. Skill saws with bonus tungsten carbide saw blade included were $79.99, now only $59.99. Ryobi angle grinder with 100mm blade size was $49.99, now $39.99. Epic building supplies, feast of savings sale. Open 7 days a week, Richmond, Parkside and Salisbury.
Back live with action as West Adelaide are absolutely powering themselves off. Down in towards the left full forward pocket. Murette must be very close to the best man on the ground, but I think that Dale Woodhull would just about get it. This is his 10th kick coming up from Peter Murette, right towards the square it goes. Stephen Miller couldn't take it. Heiner's there. They're in plenty of trouble. Conlon's got it, has a little snap. Won't come back. No, it won't. In actual fact, it'll go out of play on the full and the left full forward pocket.
Bernie Conlon, known as Smurf. Bruce Winter. One of Norwood's better players tonight. He's played a superb game in defence. Kick number 12. Goes to the half-back flank. Big Neil Hine can't take the mark. He should have marked it. Des Herbert pulled off the ball. And a free kick will take place. Des Herbert, who had a scintillating first quarter. A heavy knock in the second quarter, then left the ground. In towards full forward. Tommy Warhurst, socks down, jumper out as always, short to Rowan Hellier. Thomas, it's not a good handball, Norden not performing well under pressure. Carl Herbert, number 15, Hellier there, and the umpire will call for a bounce. The umpire is Laurie Asen. Look at that sight, a magnificent night of football here at headquarters. A big crowd, 15,020 people have witnessed a great performance by West Adelaide.
Conlon, taken by Des Herbert, tackled high, holding the ball, says the umpire. He said, in fact, that Herbert ducked his head into it. So, Taylor, only his 5th kick for tonight. What a quiet one. And there's a good mark by Cameron Lattis. West Adelaide really have been superior tonight. Well, no, the umpire has played it the other way. He's played a push in the back, and the free kick's gone Norwood's way. Keith Thomas has the ball on the outer side. Michael Annie from the side, Fortchard. Grosser, was it, that threaded it towards the boundary. I was saying that Norwood have been well beaten by a far superior side tonight as Ron Andrews comes onto the ground and Roger Luders leaves it. And this really has been a top performance by the Bloods. Taylor bangs Norwood back to Gallagher. Still looks a bit short in his action. That's only his 5th kick. It looks for Button. Fortchard playing in the unaccustomed role of back pocket tonight. Thomas bursts his way clear. Slips it over in the direction of Roberts. Doing the mopping up operation was Randall Bennett. Williams comes away with it. Jarvis and McKinnon close to the line. Jarvis controls it well. A diving attempt by McIntosh. Well, there's a push in the back to Scanlon. It goes unnoticed. The umpire, in fact, has said that Scanlon lay on the ball. McIntosh is not happy. I thought he may have got a 15-metre penalty kick against him, but now Bennett it is who kicks it towards centre wing.
Randall Bennett's kick was not marked by Peter Murette. And Peter Murette mightn't get the man of the match tonight, but by golly, he would certainly get the most skillful player on the ground as Gallagher drives it towards Vow. Danninger couldn't take the mark. On the ground is Button, desperately trying to get it. Cantalaftis is there as well. And every team that plays against West Adelaide in season 85 will know they've been playing football at the conclusion of the match. Bernie Conlon having a well-earned drink. Back live with the game. Murette seems to have all the time in the world to do something. Lester Ross, clever play to Justin Scanlon. Norwood work it forward, trying to get it was Roberts, not quite good enough. Michael Ashe works his way through. Back it goes, Roberts is there. Gets away, gets a little kick in. Interception and taken away by Lamb. Out towards the halfback play. McIntosh bursting through. Normally a left footer, kicks with his right. Fortchard takes the lead.
Fortchard, he's playing on Rocky Roberts for the entire game. Comes to the halfback flank. Randall Bennett, Justin Scanlon. Well, that's the classic catch of the year. Goes to Rowan Hellier. In towards full forward going Norwood. Up goes Roberts. Off hands by Danninger. Can't handle the ball. Dreyer is there. Candelaftis appealing for a holding the ball decision. But umpire Rick Kinnear will call for a bounce. Fan at top there. That's Johnny Candelaftis, smile on his face. as we see Rocky Roberts get to his feet. Glorious shot here at Football Park. Bounce down. West Adelaide through Filkey, coming towards centre wing, kick towards the boundary line. Will it fall in play? It does. And there'll be a throw in just in front of the grandstand here at Football Park. Top game of footy, 15,020 people here at Football Park on Nine's Wide World of Sports. Boundary umpire, Shaw, Hine in front to Gallagher. Sat upon by Leon Grosser, and once more the ball out of play.
So almost 15 minutes gone in this final term. And it's going to be a West Adelaide premiership. You can bet your boots on that. Herbert from behind. Gallagher spins out of trouble, does it well. Now where's the handball going? The handball hasn't been good in the last few minutes. McIntosh on his wrong foot again. Roberts on a lead at centre half forward. Flanked by Jarvis. Here's an opportunity for Norwood as Jarvis' kick has been smothered. Into the pocket it goes. Bardeniga. Williams hold. An umpire Kinnear decides on a bounce. And there's Jeff Morris, who started the match on the ground and then went to the interchange bench. And he's warming up to come back on again. Meanwhile, the action's on the outer side and umpire Argent has paid a free kick. It will go West Adelaide's way. Carl Herbert gives it to Kantalaftis. Almost ran himself into trouble. Pellier from behind, not paid. Hamilton. Bennett, been a very fine player for West Adelaide. And there's Herbert, who was a star in that first quarter. Got a heavy knock, and he's back in the action again. Hamilton had a good duel with McIntosh. Perhaps the honours with McIntosh. Grosser shrugs the tackle. Short, looks for Woodall. He's booted eight, can't take that one. Out it comes, Warhurst, Michael Taylor, ducks ahead, through he goes, well tackled, and that's good umpiring, allowing the play to go on until finally he picks out a free kick, and it's gone West Adelaide's way at centre-half forward.
Jeff Morris warming up. Forward goes the ball, and Kantalaftis, who has come a long way down ground, normally plays in the back pocket. This will be kick number 13 for John Kantalaftis. Long kick goes in towards the square, won't make the distance. Bruce Winter is up there, couldn't take the mark. 17 minutes have gone in the grand final. 4 minutes plus time. On Ronnie Andrews, a cut from, a goal.
Dying moments of the final quarter as Roberts has a boot for goal and kicks it through. Well, Norwood get their ninth. It came from Roberts. That's his fourth. It's a belated goal, but Rick Davies, Norwood now are gone.
Yes, I think the powerful machine of the West Adelaide side, let's face it, we've said it all night, they're going to be a very, very hard side to beat. And they've proved it tonight. Not only were they tackling, but were they shooting up forward. Woodhall with 7 or 8 goals. But then again, the old fella's done a magnificent job there in kicking 4. So they've tried all night.
29 points the difference as Shaw went up there, taken by Aish. Clever footballer over to McIntosh, who's kept on battling on, taken by Jarvis. Long kick forward. Norwood try to work the ball effectively into their forward line, but it's Michael Rennie picking it up. Bennett's played very well. Randall Bennett's a very skillful footballer. In fact, that was his 15th use of the ball, taken here by Rennie. Rennie down towards the right half forward flank, and you really must pay a tribute to this man. He was knocked very heavily. He was looked to be a little concussed, but he's got up and he's got on with it. He's driven the ball right towards the full forward position. But the free kick will be taken back by Michael Taylor. What a super footballer Michael Taylor is. I was just about to say has been. Well, of course he's not, because he's got still 2 or 3 years ahead of him, and I'm sure that he will give his best. Down towards the centre position it goes. Over the top, as it's taken through by Lester Ross towards Roberts, who's booted 4. Well done, Ian Borchard. You have played well tonight. Very quickly, Kantalaftis away towards Rennie. This is a good half back line, a very strong back line from West Adelaide. They have strength, power and persistency all over the ground. Richard Hamilton, who averages 30 touchdowns every game he plays in, down towards the centre half forward position. Rowan Hanley took it away, goes Mierette. tackle, but the whistle has gone and the umpire is going to award a free kick or a mark to Rowan Hellyer.
Yes, I think he paid the mark, Ian. Winter drives long. Greg Thomas on his own. Well shepherded. Now he's got an open space. In the pocket. Drives towards the square. Scanlon from behind. Here's a chance for Scanlon. 1 point.
Good work there by the West Adelaide defence. They have been superb tonight, the West Adelaide defence. They haven't let a thing go past without Norwood making the best of their opportunities.
Craig Williams, well, not a lot of pressure applied on that occasion when he's able to kick to himself and then touch the ground, give it to Cantalaptis. Cantalaptis around the outer side of the oval, couldn't take the mark. Bardaniga's over there. Played very well, Glenn Bardaniga. Number 41 is kick two. Here's the chance for Greg Thomas. Back it goes. Held without possession of the ball or taking too long to get rid of it. Randall Bennett will take the free kick for West Adelaide. Just about to go into the time on period and it's going to be $30,000. What a mark! What a beautiful leap there from Stephen Miller. High over the top, the youngster. Very lanky footballer, a very skillful player. Down towards the centre full forward position. Barmer's there. Back it goes to Herbert. In turn to Carl Herbert. That was Des Herbert that gave it forward first. Bruce Winter there. On to Michael Ashe, who's tackled quickly. But the umpire has picked out a free kick. And your commentator will be David Darcy.
Very tired Norwood side as Neil Barmer and Glenn Ross are obviously very disappointed with their display tonight. West Adelaide too persistent, too strong, too fast. All over the ground. Gallagher. Jarvis. Now the umpire's picked out something. I can't believe what that one is. Throwing the ball, was it, Rick?
Well, I think that Ronnie Andrews grabbed him by the arm and as he went through to do the handball, it slipped out the end and of course the umpire was right on the scene.
Well, the free has gone the way of Ron Andrews. He's got it about 45 metres out. Torpedo punt will not go the full distance. Hall has front position and the big fella takes the mark. Almost got his head pulled off. Michael Ashe had a wonderful game for Norwood. 16 kicks and 11 handballs. Bennett for West Adelaide. 15 kicks and 8 handballs has played an exceptional game. But probably Dale Woodhall with his 8 goals will be the man of the match tonight. We'll wait on that decision. That will be given to you after the final siren. Bardaniga takes it for Norwood. Scanlon runs into the open goal. He's going to be caught, but he still gets his kick. And Scanlon has kicked Norwood's 10th goal and his first. Rick Davies.
Yes, well, even though that Scanlon was out in the open there, the West Adelaide still managed to grab him by the Guernsey and put him under a little bit of pressure. Although the ball came down there very quickly, as we see here on the replay, the ball shot out there by Michael Annie, trapped by Bardaniga. He gets the handball over to Scanlon, shoots away. See the fella there, the West Adelaide player in Rennie still manages to get his glove on him, but he's the goal comes up.
2 minutes into the time on now. 22 points the difference. It's West Adelaide okay. John Hall to Ashe. Ashe kicking down towards the centre half forward position. Scanlon there, and so has Rennie. Been very impressed with Michael Rennie's performance tonight, and he's been well supported by Lamb. Back it goes, looking for Grosser. Grosser seconds McGarry medalist. Away he goes. Kicks the ball down towards the centre half forward position. Can't get it. Conlon there. Tackles his opponent. And Jarvis. And Conlon felt that he would have liked to have got that. In the dying stages of the Escort Cup Championship. As out it goes to Craig Baum. Finds Taylor. McIntosh. McIntosh to Greg Thomas. And Norwood worked the ball forward. They must be commended for the way that they've kept on keeping on. They've not given up one little bit. And it's taken by Shaw. Shaw out towards the outer side of the oval looking for Lamb. And Lamb has taken the mark.
So we've played 3 minutes of time on in this final quarter. And the Escort Cup will rest safely in the West Adelaide club rooms. And there's a very elated, I would think, John Cale. Having come back to South Australia in his very first encounter, winning a premiership. Oh, she's on. Oh! Socceroos. Here we go. Where's Jacko? There's the siren. The game's all over. But she's on the other side of the ground now. Common sense should prevail here. Umpire Kinnear comes in to settle them down. John Carl's happy. He's won. He's not interested in proceedings over there. So a great performance that by West Adelaide, and Neil Baum is a dejected man. West Adelaide have won the 1985 Escort Cup 14-9, defeating Norwood 10-11. We'll take a break and then come back here to Football Park in just a moment.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm certain you'll agree with me. We've just seen a magnificent final of the 1985 Escort Cup. A tremendous performance by both sides, West Adelaide and Norwood. It is indeed my pleasure to call upon the President of the South Australian National Football League, Mr. Max Bashir, to make the necessary presentations. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Max Bashir.
Thank you very much, Ken. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to thank you very much for your support for the Escort Series, and we look forward to your support for the coming season. It's obviously going to be a great season, and I'd like to think that you'll come back in your numbers to watch these great teams play. I want to thank all of the league clubs for their cooperation during the series, and in particular, WD and HO Wills for their generous support in the sponsorship that they've made available to us. I want to take the opportunity of thanking all of the country leagues for their help and assistance in the matches that we played at their own towns. The first cheque that I have to present tonight is to the man of the match, and that's been won by Dale Woodall of West Adelaide. Dale. Dale, would you come forward, please? Dale kicked 8 goals tonight. A great performance. Congratulations.
I'd just like to thank WD and HO Wills for their tremendous sponsorship. It's been a great carnival, and all the teams competed, and most of all, the boys at West Adelaide. Tremendous. Well done, fellas.
Thank you. That's yours, that's yours. Dale was trying to give it back to me, but the runner-up cheque, a cheque for $20,000, goes to Norwood, and I ask Michael Ace to come forward and receive it.
Thank you very much, Max. Just like to thank WD and HO Wills for putting up the competition. Great stuff, and this cheque, I suppose, will go to a worthy cause. Congratulations to West Adelaide, too good on the day. They are very well. Thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, I think you'll all agree that West Adelaide thoroughly deserved their win tonight. And it is my very great pleasure to ask their captain, Ian Borchard, to come and accept this cheque for $30,000. Ian. Well done. Congratulations, Ian.
Thanks, Max. Firstly, I'd just like to say what the other players had to say. Thank you kindly to WD and HO Wills for making the competition available and possible. I think it's been a good lead up to what should be a great season, and I hope we can be back here again in a few months' time, get the bigger one. Thanks very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, we've previously handed 2 envelopes, one to Port Adelaide for $10,000 and one to Glenelg for $15,000.
Thank you very much, Max. It is indeed my pleasure now to call upon Mr. Bob Sage, who is the promotional manager of the company that has put forth all this money for this magnificent competition, WD and HO Wills. Ladies and gentlemen, a big round of applause for Mr. Bob Sage.
President Max Bashir, ladies and gentlemen, the changes introduced this year to the Escort Cup format have changed the concept completely of the Escort Cup into a totally pre-season competition. I feel sure the format has been well accepted, and I'd like to congratulate the South Australian National Football League on a very innovative and very successful 1985 Escort Cup series. I'd also like to congratulate the West Adelaide and Norwood football clubs for progressing through to the grand final tonight. And now I have much pleasure in asking Ian Borchardt to come forward and accept the 1985 Escort Cup trophy.
Well, thank you very much, mate. Thank you again. This is the boys. They've worked very hard to achieve this. It's just the start. We've got a lot more to do. Thanks very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, three cheers for West Adelaide. Hip hip. Hip hip. Hip hip. Thanks to Mr. Max Bashir and Mr. Bob Sage. And ladies and gentlemen, thank you for coming.
Certainly three cheers for West Adelaide and three cheers for you.
Well, it was nice to win both, but the boys have been very, very well. Very coachable, listen, and really proud of something. Just the next round.
Yeah, it is. Actually, more time from coaching, and it was a real pleasure because they got the results.
Physically strong, so I haven't seen a West Adelaide side apply that much pressure and that much strength ever.
Well, you know,
what do you think about it?
Well, I think just the gym work they have been doing, and it's just built up a little bit of power and a bit of strength, Dave. And we still can improve, which is good. And
where would you improve on that?
Oh, I think we can improve. Well, we had some players out there that can lift. There were some important players out there that can lift a lot, and I think that if we can get that power and strength going with the running game, I'd just like to win the first game.
Yeah, right. You had a tremendous start tonight, though, and Woodhall's performance was superb.
He's very good around the goals. He's a very good kick, David. He finds the ball, he knows where it's at, and he's got good recovery for a full forward, so it worries a full back.
Well, Jack, congratulations once again, and good luck now for the rest of the season. I'm sure West Adelaide on that performance have got to be right in it now.
Thanks, David.
Thanks. Fantastic performance. John Carl. And KG, she's been a long time and a fantastic time. You've enjoyed the Escort Cup. The last 6 weeks have been fantastic, haven't they?
Well, it's amazing, Darcy, when you're having a good time, just how quick time flies. And it just seems that, it started last week and it's been fantastic. We've covered, 18 games. We've been from Whyalla up to Mount Gambier and back. We've had some wonderful times. We've seen great footy. And it is a pity that it's all finished. I've thoroughly enjoyed it. How about yourself?
Yeah, I think it's been fantastic.
Well, I certainly hope the people at home, Darcy, have had the enjoyment we've had here at Football Park and the various country areas. It's been super football, and we hope you've enjoyed our coverage here on Channel 9. So, ladies and gentlemen, sit back now as we show you some of the great highlights of the Escort Cup competition for 1985. Thanks for being with us.